three wheels on my wagon, and I'm still rolling along. The Cherokees are chasing me, arrows fly right on by, but I'm singing a happy song. I'm singing a higgity, higgity, hoggity, high. On my wagon, and I'm still rolling along. Them Cherokees are after me. Flaming spears burn my ears, but I'm singing a happy song. I'm singing a higgity, haggity, hoggity, high. Pioneers, they never say die. Half a mile up the road, there's a
hill. Walk away, walk away, walk away. That's what they say, what they say, what they say. You have to say. There's the woman there. Why are you hanging around the entrance and then snitching?
There we have a crazy lady. This was very strange. From the moment I clamped eyes on her, she was really on her toes, looking over, going on a phone, hiding behind a bush. And even though about 30 police cars, police staff and also marked cars came and went, never said a dicky bird to me. She was then shouting at me that photography is unlawful. Right at the end.
Check card. Jesus.
That's what I see. Oh, quick.
I am, thank you.
Can I help you at all?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
What's the scope of the offer?
Scope of the offer, sir. Obviously, you're on the police station private property at the moment, aren't you?
I knew you'd say obviously within the first two sentences.
Yeah, go on. What's going on and what are you here for?
I'm just thinking, I've got to go exercising my rights.
Okay, and what rights are you exercising then?
Well, Article 8, Article 10, Article 2.
Okay.
You'd be familiar with all them, wouldn't you?
Okay. I'll be honest with you, I'm not, no.
Okay. Why did you ask them?
What I ask?
Why did you ask which rights I was?
I'm just curious to know. Yeah, we're into the conversation here, aren't we?
Yeah.
It's your opportunity to educate me as much as anything else, isn't it?
Are you filming me?
Yes.
Okay, you're supposed to tell me before you're filming me.
Okay. The reason why I'm filming
you... Hold on. You're supposed to tell me, aren't you? I know, but it's...
As soon as practicable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
So as soon as practicable...
I'm not your mate. Take your hands out of your pockets, please.
Why?
Because it's in your policy. You're addressing the public. You don't stand there with your hands in your pockets.
I'm just talking to you, aren't I? I don't know what the problem is.
Okay, well, if you're not going to do that, I don't really have much respect for you.
Talk to my colleague. Talk to me, then.
Okay, I'm going to have to whisper, then, all right?
That's fine. We'll take a step over here. You're on private property, mate.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter if it's private. It matters whether it's publicly accessible.
Okay. Yeah.
So it's publicly accessible. And, okay.
Will you leave the property? I'm asking you a question.
Why would you want me to leave?
I'm asking you, will you leave the property?
I will leave. I do have to go home tonight, so I will leave.
Yeah.
Some point.
Okay. So just say, you're walking around, you're taking photographs of people's vehicles around here as well, aren't you?
Is that unlawful?
I mean, it makes people feel uncomfortable, doesn't it?
Okay, but is that unlawful?
It's morally a bit wrong, isn't it?
Is it? Because the police never photograph other people's vehicles, do they?
Not for our own benefit, no. It gets stored on police databases.
I don't believe that. Yeah. I know, but there's enough misconduct hearings where police have actually used the police computers for non-policing purposes, aren't they? So that would be incorrect to say that,
wouldn't it? There's not be tantamount to that, then. If you're saying things for our own private purposes, this isn't for like a police
purpose. No, because...
taking photographs of buildings and stuff.
Oh, no, it isn't, but I'm a member of the public. Okay. You're in... my employee, so to speak, aren't you? You're a Crown servant.
When
you sign up, you sign up to these policies.
Okay. What's your purpose here, taking photographs of, say...
Well, remember when I said it was Article 8?
Private vehicles.
No, they're not private. If they're private, they're in the garage and nobody sees it. It's a little bit like an opinion. If you have a private opinion,
yeah,
you don't...
It's a private vehicle as opposed to a
public... I'm sorry, my friend,
vehicle.
I'm not talking to you. Oh, you're taking your hands out of your pockets. Okay, yes. Okay, yeah, no, I will talk to you now.
It's just the same as if you had your car in your drive and people would take your photos. You'd be a bit concerned, wouldn't you, that's all?
No, it's different because I pay for that property and it's not publicly accessible. Whereas this, I help pay for as well as you. And it is publicly accessible.
This part of the car park isn't publicly accessible.
It is.
Are you sure about
yeah.
that? Okay. I'll take you on your word at
okay,
that.
Okay, Section 33.
On it,
Section 33, 1972, Criminal Justice Act. If you want to check it out.
Okay, I'll check that out. I'll be honest with you, I'm not up to that.
That's okay.
I don't do this on day in, day
every
out.
Every day's
a
school day.
I do a proper policing things on a day in, day out. You know what I mean? So.
Thank you.
Anything? Hey, I am. Hey? Yeah, you can. I am.
You're taking photographs of people's private vehicles. Okay. Not public property ones, you refer to as the police vehicles, which I get comes out of the taxpayer's wallet.
Well, what you've got to think is this, is that the public are allowed to put you under scrutiny, aren't they?
Yeah.
And if I want to photograph your private plate, check out whether the tax and MOT'd, and if I want to see if there's any damage on them, that's okay, that's fine, I can do that. Just in the same way that you can do it also.
We get calls day in, day out of people saying, somebody outside my address, they're going up and down the road, they're taking photographs of cars, it's really suspicious, it makes me feel uncomfortable, can you come out and sort this out, please? Do you understand why people ring us
and do you?
Sort that out? So can you understand where I'm coming from when I say...
Do you though?
We do, yeah.
You do that? So every time somebody phones you and says there's somebody outside looking at my car, you go out to them, do you? Yeah.
We're getting tangible.
You don't, do you?
I get deployed according to this, don't I? It's triage system.
Exactly.
Yeah. If we are all dealing with a murder, you can appreciate... If every single unit's dealing with a murder, we do not have a unit free to go and deal with a guy taking photographs of somebody's car on the street. You understand that, don't you?
Well,
I appreciate that.
Photographers would perhaps disagree, because what we do is, if we've been sort of victims
we're coming on to whether we deploy to a job or not.
Okay. I'm getting there. This is a meandering conversation, which is... photographers like me know that you often deploy officers as fast as that, whether we're at Asda, whether we're at Chemical Works, whether we're at photographing in the city, at the bank or whatever, a private building, you're there. If they have a problem with themselves at home, somebody breaking in, they often won't see a policeman. So the deployment issue, we're going to have to disagree on that.
Okay. But what you are stating is we were deployed to somebody taking photographs of people's cars in the street. That was the point you made then.
What I'm saying is that what I would do is I would say to them, well, are they breaking the law?
Okay.
Do you go out for people that aren't breaking the law?
People are concerned, don't they?
Okay, but people are concerned over different things, aren't they? Okay.
Right now, I'm concerned about photographs being taken of police officers' vehicles in the car park.
Well, that's okay. Listen.
My concern on that is what you're going to do with those photos.
Well, that's okay. You can be concerned.
Because you've got to appreciate there are people who may not be... They may not be as...
nice.
Yeah.
Well, that's okay. That's okay.
Right. I mean, that's why I should have moved on now. It is a private car park, okay?
I'm allowed to be here.
I think you're here for the confrontation, if I'm honest.
You're not
going to get one out of me. I'm not confrontational. I have no gripe with you at all. We're having a conversation, aren't we?
Right.
I'm not being confrontational.
Well, let me respond. Let me respond. I'm not after the confrontation, because why would anybody come out to a person that's doing a lawful activity? Why would you do that?
Why
if I was walking a dog here, you wouldn't come out.
Anyone on this property here who's not a police officer, I'm going to come out and speak with them, aren't I? Let's be honest.
Well, I don't mind leaving, because I'm almost done.
But what is your aim here?
Well, that's it. You know, when I was mentioned Article 8?
Yeah.
Which is right
to
privacy.
That's your right to do so.
My right to privacy.
But not why.
Yeah, but the intent and motivation.
So right to privacy.
Is your right to privacy.
Don't these police officers have a right to privacy?
Not out in public.
Well, you're in public, aren't you?
Yeah.
So you don't have a right to... Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying...
You're not trying to educate me
I'm
here.
Saying that thoughts and intent and motivation and reasons, anything that's inside and hidden, that's my right to privacy.
Okay.
I'm right to free thought, and I'm right to think. Okay. Because if it wasn't...
I'm just curious
that would be
totalitarianism,
wasn't it?
I'm just curious to know what your motivation is, photographing vehicles.
You can, that's
I'm not,
that's
I'm
fine.
I'm not trying to get it out of your lawful.
That's fine. No, that's fine.
It's a conversation,
but,
isn't it?
But what I'm saying is that bit is confidential.
Okay. Okay. I understand that. So you're not willing to say why you're here taking photos. I'm just curious to know what your motivation is.
I'm exercising my rights.
Yeah, exercising your rights to...
To be creative, to receive and impart information, and to be creative with that.
It may surprise you, I'm a photographer.
Oh, yeah.
I love photography.
Good.
I've got a Canon 70D, it's perhaps not as fancy as your one there. You're looking at yours, I'm saying that's probably about 4,500 to 5,000, including the lens, whereas mine's only about 1,200. So it's nowhere near the quality of yours. I do love a photo, though. However... Yeah. I choose my subjects for their aesthetic appeal, for their look. I'm giving you an insight into my inner work and my thought process now. So I like to photograph things that appeal to me. I'm the photographer. I don't take photographs for anybody else, I take them for myself. I'm just curious
what
the appeal
do you take?
Is. Animals, buildings, scenery, landscapes. Predominantly animals, though.
Okay.
So
that's all I've done here.
Animals?
We're all animals, aren't we?
Oh, okay, well, I'm going to say there's a difference.
Are we animals?
We are animals.
Are you Homo sapien? On your hominid?
If I go in someone's garden and take a picture of their cat without their permission, it's a bit weird, isn't it?
Yeah, no. That would be unlawful. Or rather, it would be trespass, because you're going on somebody else's property.
This is somebody else's property.
We've been through, you know, this is publicly accessible.
We are asking you to leave.
And I will leave. You want me to leave this minute? I will leave this minute.
Yeah, I would like you to leave this minute. I've enjoyed the conversation.
Okay.
Okay. Can you understand why it makes people like myself feel really uneasy having people taking photographs of their cars?
No, because I think it's paranoia.
People who may not be as innocently minded as yourself,
okay,
and may have a devious undertone in what they want to do if those images become publicly available.
Give me an example then. So let's say, for instance, I'll take a picture of this lady's car here who phoned you in and complained about me. Okay, so I've got a shot of her car now.
Okay.
And it goes online. Let's say I put it online tonight.
Yeah.
Then what happens?
And then somebody finds out where that car's registered to, or where it's been driving around. It can be put on there for various people we deal with, saying, this is a police officer's vehicle now. I'm stating it's a police officer's vehicle, as you've just said.
Okay.
It's then now knowledge it's a police officer's vehicle. That officer is now at risk of repercussions of people who may not be as innocently minded as yourself.
Right.
Do you understand where I'm coming from?
No. I'll tell you why. Because I could come down here and see that with my own eyes.
You could, yeah.
I could put anything online like that. You wouldn't have stopped me if I was just walking across here. If I was stood on the perimeter and I'm looking in, you wouldn't stop me. Okay, so that, to my mind, is nonsense. The other point I want to make is that I know police that actually have private registrations, and they have 999 as their registration, right? Now, doesn't seem like they're too terrified of being...
I'm going to agree with you on that one. I don't understand why people have that.
Yeah.
It's a choice, isn't it? If people want to have a private plate with that on, they're welcome to.
It is a choice. But what it does is, it kills that argument, doesn't it?
But I don't.
It's not for everyone, is it?
Now, the other point is...
I feel uncomfortable. Okay. I'm not speaking on behalf of everyone else in that building. So do you see where I'm coming from now?
No.
Person to person, I feel uncomfortable.
So
this isn't police officer talking. Person to person, I feel uncomfortable.
Right,
so you may have taken a photograph of my vehicle.
Then we have a problem, because what you then do is you raise yourself, you put yourself on a pedestal, and you say we should be exempt. Now, what you shouldn't be doing is going to the photographer and saying, I don't like you doing that lawful activity. You should be lobbying your MP, and then he can draw up a paper, everybody can vote on it, and if they agree that photographers shouldn't photograph policemen's cars, police officers' cars, fine. But what you shouldn't be doing is trying to enforce law on your opinion. And that's what you're doing. You're saying, I'm uncomfortable, I'm concerned, as if your concern and your comfort is more important than me. There's loads of things that go on that I don't find comfortable.
The risk to me and my family, I would say, is higher than the risk of somebody finding out your registration plate because of the people that I deal with on a daily basis. Okay. I interrupt their criminal activities. I stop them from dealing drugs. I stop them from various other things that I don't want to talk about because they're horrible, horrible things. But you know the type of things we deal with predominantly, yeah?
Let me come back at you that one then.
Go on then.
I'm at more risk of dying in your hands than you are in the hands of the public.
My hands?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so that's a stat if you want to look up. I am more likely to be killed by our police than I am by a terrorist.
And I'd have to say, why'd you walk into a police station car park if you're that afraid of police officers?
Because I didn't say I was afraid of them, but my rights are important.
Mm.
My rights are important. If we don't exercise them, we lose them.
Okay, I appreciate
so the fact that. The fact that a lot of the public have been killed by the police won't put me off coming here and exercising my rights.
Okay. You have to understand as well.
You keep saying that you have to understand. You need to term it differently, because it sounds really patronising. No, the difference is that when you say to somebody, obviously, or you say to somebody...
That's my turn of phrase and my use of words, isn't it?
You have to understand. Well, when you say you have to understand, it's as if there's a conclusion there already out there. You've managed to grasp it. I'm yet to catch on.
That's
what it says. You've got to understand. Well, no.
There who use the word literally, and it frustrates me because it's in completely wrong context.
We're
all guilty of it. I'm obviously using the word obviously in the wrong context.
Obviously.
That's a habit of
It's
a habit we pick up on, isn't it?
It is a police thing.
What I'm saying, it's not a police thing.
I'm telling you it is.
Okay, well, I started to say it is my previous job in retail, so I don't know where I got it from.
Well, if you go online and you look at any encounters with the police, you will have the first three sentences will be obviously will be in there. You got to understand, and you got to appreciate. Okay.
Now, when you put them together, you might think, well, it's just a turn of phrase, but it isn't. It's actually making the photographer into a supplicant. It's saying, I'm up here, I know shit, you don't know it, but you might grasp it if you hang on in there.
First thing I said to you was, I don't know. Please educate me. Correct me if I'm wrong. It's on your camera.
I'll have a look later.
You've got me saying that, yeah? Me saying
it. No, I'm just saying about that it's prevalent.
Please educate me, yeah.
It's prevalent with police.
I don't put myself
police.
Above anyone. What I do, but if my own uncomfortable, I feel uncomfortable, and I'm asking you.
Can I also tell you as well that if your registration, I mean, I can take your registration. If I want to know where one of you lived, just follow you home.
Yeah.
I wouldn't
people do that.
You know,
understand that as well, don't you?
Yeah, but that's nothing to do with photography.
No.
That's nothing to do with the photographer.
But putting those images and those things out there and making them more easily accessible.
All right. But talk me through the bit where some let's say there's some nasty guy out there, right? Bank robber. Mm. And he's watching whatever I've put online. And then he sees a car, or he searches for it because he's crazed and he's after a certain officer. And he thinks, I know what I'll do. I'll go through every video on Facebook, on TikTok, on Instagram, on YouTube, because there might just be a shot of a car on there with an officer maybe getting in it, and then I'm going to have him because I've got access to a bent copper that will look it up online, find out the address, because that's what can happen, and the police have been prosecuted for it.
Oh, I appreciate it.
And so on and so forth. Yeah. But I don't think that would happen. I honestly don't think that would happen. In fact, if you can give me an instance, if you can give me an instance where a photographer like myself has photographed a personal car, put it online, and then the police have been targeted because of that photograph.
It makes it more easily accessible, though.
Okay. I'm gathering that's a no. You can't give me an example.
I can't give you an example, no.
Okay.
There's many things I can't give you an example of. It doesn't mean it's not correct, though.
Mm.
Do you accept that you make that information more easily and readily accessible when you put photographs online stating these are...
If I come out...
Police station car park.
Anybody does. Dash cam. You're going out here and a guy with a dash cam comes past, or the girl, dash cam.
Do you accept that you make that information more easily accessible, though?
I accept that our rights... I accept that we should not exchange our liberty for security.
Mm-hmm.
That was what I would say.
Yeah.
And I think that was Lincoln who said that. People are willing to exchange their liberty for security should have neither. And what you have to realise is that the Joe public out there can go about their business. It doesn't necessarily endanger you, but if it does, then you need to change the law on it and not just come out here with any petty concerns and say, you shouldn't be doing this, I can't stop you, but you're making me uncomfortable and I'm concerned and type of thing, you know.
My right is to tell you I feel uncomfortable there. You acknowledge that, surely.
But yeah, of course it is, yeah.
And your actions are making me feel uncomfortable.
Yeah,
you acknowledge.
But you're in
moment, so
working today.
I'm not being rude, I just need to speak to this person, bear with.
What's wrong with this card? Jesus. I don't even know it's got a fucking card. Check card. What's your name, anyway?
PC Farley.
How long have you been a cop of PC Farley?
A little while.
And your first name's not Charlie, is it?
No.
Okay.
My parents didn't do that to me.
Okay.
But we've just come out to engage in conversation.
Okay.
That's all it is.
It's all right. What's your calling number, my friend?
It's on my shoulders, 21656, if you can
okay.
see that.
Okay, thank you very much.
not a problem.
And what do you specialise in? Have you ever been disciplined?
That would be for me to know and to say.
Okay, have you ever been the subjects of a misconduct hearing?
No.
Okay, have you ever tased anybody?
I don't carry tasers, you can tell, so.
Okay. No, the answer is, I wouldn't. I haven't and I wouldn't. Not I don't carry a taser, because it makes you think that you would if you did.
Well, obviously it's there to use, isn't it? So it's a tool, as well as anything else. We've got any personal protective
equipment. What's that you got there?
Should we use this Parva incapacitant spray?
Oh, the pepper spray, is it?
Standard baton. Yeah, it's a part.
You ever use that?
That's for me, isn't it? I don't want to talk about that currently.
Why not? You know, what about accountability and transparency?
I understand that.
So you have used it? Okay.
I'm not going to go
And did it work?
I'm not going to go into details.
Did it work when you used it?
Yeah.
It did. So you have used it? Okay.
I might have been on myself at my right. training.
Is it any good for if you've made like a chili or whatever, you know, and you've ran out of spices, if you spray a bit on there?
Okay. Honest.
In the same way that I don't suppose you could throw a chili at somebody in their eyes and incapacitate them either, could you? Or maybe with realms of fantasy, you know.
Who knows? Obviously, as my colleague said, this section is private property. We've asked if you go. You said you would. Are you willing to do so?
I am. As soon as you have finished with me, I will.
Finish with you?
I will go. Yeah. Okay. Nice to talk to you. What are the badges?
Badges. That's my driving badge, and that's from when I ran the New York Marathon for a charity last year. So
okay.
My PD badge on there.
Right.
So.
Okay. Good to chat. Hope you've learned something.
I say I'm always open for discussion. You've got to, and I'm saying this, these are my words, not police words. You've got to appreciate how uncomfortable makes people feel.
Okay.
Yeah. Your actions make people feel uncomfortable when you come to the car.
Well, you do some shit that make us feel bad as well, you know.
I don't, personally. I can't speak for every officer in the same way you can't speak for every photographer.
Okay.
You appreciate that?
Yeah, but I was talking about the police, not just you.
Yeah, but you're talking about a small number.
You have been disciplined.
Well, I've been disciplined.
Yeah.
What, in police or in school or
in police?
In police, no.
Have you ever been the subject of a misconduct hearing?
No.
Okay, good man. All right.
I don't. All I asked before we go.
But he's pepper sprayed somebody. Have you tasered anybody?
I've never tased anyone because I use my mouth.
Okay, what, you watch bite them?
No, I talk people down. I'm talking, okay? I pepper spray people though because some of the people you deal with, you've got to appreciate that as well. That's our way of getting a conversation across people. Yeah, otherwise I could go to a whole lengthy explanation as to why. Yeah.
Well, you could have done it today. This would all have been over in 10 seconds.
You don't need to. Yeah, we had a conversation. But before you go, can you understand my point of view where it makes me and other people feel uncomfortable when there's a car park and take photographs?
Yeah, but if it does, it's not a problem. It's not an insurmountable problem. I know that there's like fear therapy that you're offered by the police force if it's irrational. Mm. And I think it's irrational.
Okay.
I just think it's... when I say it's irrational, I think that the probability... You tend to go on the possibility. If something's possible, it's, well, you know, this could happen, you know. Like, you know, like the incident in France where the officers got killed in the station. Well, you know, what you've got to do is think, well, all right, that's happened. It's never happened before. It probably won't happen again. Or if it does happen again, we can't really sort of safeguard against it massively, but we just got to carry on.
I wear a seatbelt every day in my car.
Yeah.
It's not probability, it's possibility.
It's a law.
Yeah. Let's ignore the law, even when it's not the law. You know, my old job, I had to drive across a car park, open one gate on one side, one gate on the other. It's private property, didn't have to wear my seatbelt. I still wore it because I feel safer wearing it. It's not probability, it's possibility.
It is, but how many people die, you know, like that in Britain every month? There's hundreds that die of it. But how many times has a photographer taken a picture of a car? Gangsters got hold of the picture of a car, decided to do some research, gone round to the house. It doesn't happen. I don't think it's ever happened, and I don't think it does happen. I think it's just paranoia from the police.
We'll have to agree to disagree.
All right.
Yeah. Obviously, you don't deal with the type of people we deal with on a daily basis.
You don't know that?
Well, I hope you don't. I sincerely hope you don't, because if you do, it's a horrible situation for you. Yeah. Some people we deal with there, they stab people, they burn people. They put them through chipping machines, wood chipping machines. They're horrible, horrible people.
Is that your colleagues?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. These are members of the public that we have the misfortune of dealing with.
Because you've got some bad colleagues as well, haven't you? I mean, there's been three cases.
None that I know.
Three cases in the last month, haven't you? You've had four people. You've obviously the footballer that was tasered for over 30 seconds, then booted in the head, he died. You've had the Wayne Cousins that murdered that girl. And then you've had, like, in Liverpool, I think four of them were jailed-worthy, or one was suspended for beating some bloke up in his kitchen who wasn't off. Nobody, so you know...
No one hates a bent copper more than a copper, I can assure you.
Yeah. Well, hopefully.
Because we're the ones who go out and get them.
Hopefully.
Ultimately, we're the ones who bring them to justice.
You ever arrested a bent copper?
No. I look forward
you
to it.
You reported one?
I've never met one.
Okay.
If I did, you can bet your bottom dollar I'd report them.
You never met one? You think you never met one, or you mean you've just not been
I
aware?
I think I've never met one.
Okay.
Okay. I'm not aware of one, let's phrase it correctly then.
What about this guy? Is this guy all right, or...?
As far as I'm aware.
Yeah,
he's never suggested to me otherwise. If he does, I'll be the first to report him, though.
All right.
Anyway, it's been a pleasure
meeting
you.
Okay, good. All right. It's just a private project.
For what? Because.
Well, there's a clue in the word private.
Yeah, but there's a clue in the word that this is MOD establishment.
Doesn't matter.
We don't normally have pictures taken at the site. MOD government doesn't allow it.
They can't stop it.
Okay.
Do you know the law? Do you know the law?
Well, better be alright, I'm safe, but you know. Use a bit of common sense.
What does that concern you? I'm on public, you work in there, I'm out here.
Alright, so you just take your pictures around here, or... Okay.
Just go away. See you soon.
Anyway,
have a good night. Anyway. Bye now. Where the fucking hell is this not working? Twat! Aha! Yeah, that's exactly how I feel, mate.